Thanks to everyone who's helped to make Yamaha's DM7 series of digital mixers so successful so quickly. They were already packed with a versatile range of features, but now version 1.6 brings a range of new tricks. Firstly, if you have the broadcast package, version 1.6 will bring you 5.1 surround mixing and monitoring. I've made another video to cover all the details, though basically mixed buses 1 to 12 are used for two 5.1 mixes, while matrix 1 to 4 are converted to a pair of down mix buses. Manage panning from the main touch screens. Or if you have the DM7 control panel, use the joystick. Surround monitoring includes source selection, speaker mute and solo functions, and a special downmix setup. Secondly, if you have the theater package, version 1.6 will provide immersive mixing possibilities with AFC image control. As a reminder, the broadcast and theater packages are available as individual additions for DM7 series, or they are both included with the DM7 control panel. Find my other video to see how to set up AFC image control, but to give you an idea, it allows the console to be used for remote control for the immersive mixing platform. Controlling X, Y, and Z positioning, the width and height of up to 128 audio objects. It's rather impressive, though of course it requires connection with an AFC image processor. The third new feature with version 1.6 is the support for a new optional expansion card, the PY64-D. This will add an extra 64 channels of Dante in and out of the console with the possibility of sample rate conversion. Again, I have another video to provide more details. A key point is that it allows one mixer to join two networks, or to link with equipment running at two different sample rates, such as 48 kHz and 96 kHz at the same time. Talking of Dante, version 1.6 also brings support for Dante Domain Manager, displaying the information in the Dante setup screen. And the list of Dante supported devices has expanded to include Digital Audio Labs live mix range, just like the latest version of Rivage PM series also does. Back in the network setup, we find another new feature, bus permission for the MonitorMix app. If you want to block access from the app to certain buses, you can remove permission, such as to surround buses, mix minus feeds, and so on. The buses you deselect will disappear from the MonitorMix settings to avoid unwanted adjustment of critical parameters. In the effect rack, there has been an improvement to tap tempo, in particular when recalling scenes or libraries which include effects with synchronized delay times. Now let's look at a couple of new features in the utility screen. Firstly, touching the manual icon in the home menu provides a quick link to explore the reference manual. If you're using the DM7 editor software and your computer has an internet connection, just click Explore to go directly to an online HTML version of the manual with easy navigation. Otherwise, point your mobile device's camera to the QR code. Or take a browse through the 19 different shortcuts and speed up your workflow. From EQ reset functions to scene number settings, fader navigation to temporary channel links. There's something to help everyone, and you can download the list as a PDF from our website to keep as a reminder. Our final new feature of version 1.6 is the availability of internal memory for saving and loading console files. So even if you don't have a USB drive, you can still back up your data. In the home menu of the utility screen, touch the Save Load icon. At the top left, select Internal rather than USB memory. See the list of files stored internally. If there are none there yet, why not do a backup right away? There's space for quite a lot of complete console files and individual libraries with up to 128 MB available. And there's a copy and paste facility to transfer the files to an external USB drive later. This is going to be helpful at music festivals and other events where visiting engineers will bring their own files to load and use just for a short time before the previous settings need to be reloaded. Or in a theater where multiple shows may be rehearsed and performed concurrently. So that's all the new tricks with version 1.6. It's worth updating when you have a safe gap between projects. Don't miss my other videos to find out more details about 5.1 surround mixing, immersive control with AFC Image, and the new PY64-D interface card. Bye for now.